special guest panelist all morning, but we couldn't have her on our show without sitting her down for a chat. Well, she's been seated all morning, really, and she's been chatting all morning, but we're going to talk to her even more. Simone Buchanan, it's been so great having you with us. Really timely as well, given everything that's coming out of the entertainment industry. I mean, you know, we're all sort of aghast reading about it. What are your memories of that time? Obviously, there was good stuff as well.
Yes, what are you talking about? Way back?
Fantastic.
Best time of my life. You know, when I was on the show, we had a ball. You know, it kind of it didn't taint the experience in that way at all. I mean, it wasn't till the end that that kind of stuff started.
How long did Hey Dad run?
I think it went for 10 years. I was there for about six.
And Rolf Harris, where people seem to know he was a groper, to use the description that's been given to him, were people aware that Robert Hughes was...
Acting inappropriately.
Yeah.
I think in the end there was... it was one of those things that were spoken about behind the scenes. You know, a lot of the time you go, is that just a rumour? I think sometimes you go, well, you know, it could be a rumour, I don't know.
Were you aware?
I was aware in the end when Sarah came to me about it.
Because how old were you at the time?
I think about 18 when I first...
So that's young.
Yeah, I was young.
So how then did you deal with that? Because that's a real burden to sort of share, I suppose.
Yeah, it was. I mean, obviously, we had no idea what he was doing elsewhere. I mean, we were kind of learning all of that as the trial went on, like everyone else. So at the time, it was just about Sarah, and it was a very grey area too. Which is, it's once you start talking about it, it's kind of it's interesting. But what she was saying to me was concerning, but it was stuff that easily could have been talked out of if you'd approached him, until she talked to me about the flashing incident, and that's when I said, okay, I'm done listening to this stuff. I have to take it to the producer and just say something about it, which I did. So, you know, it was a real juggle.
You doing that, because I imagine that is a hard thing to do, to actually take it higher up the chain and say, wait a minute, this is not acceptable.
Yeah, but what was his reaction?
Well, his reaction was, OK, well, let me look into it, but don't say anything about it. Yeah. And, look, nothing was done. So, you know, and we all know how it ended up, so...
It's extraordinary. And the parallels that are with the Rolf Harris case are just uncanny. Oh. I mean, the sort of idea of using the cloak of celebrity to get away with behaviour that would never be tolerated by anyone else, even to the point of disguising into some kind of flamboyance or eccentricity or, you know...
It's unbelievable, actually, looking at reading about Rolf's trial. It's almost identical, the stuff that he was doing, you know. It's very, very, very similar. So I think, you know, I think there's a lot of it that's happening or has happened in the industry. I think there's a lot that's going to... There's more to come.
Were you surprised at the severity of Rolf Harris's sentence, given that Robert Hughes got about twice that?
I was figuring maybe there's different laws in the UK than I don't know, they're looking at it differently. I'm not sure. I am very, very surprised. And I think I noticed that there are a lot of people that have just... I think saw last night 13 more girls, women came forward. I know with Robert there were many, many, many more that had come forward that we couldn't use in the trial because of certain reasons. But they were very quick this time to come forward. I think the more cases there are, the more people will speak up with confidence.
He played your dad for 6 years on Hey Dad. What was it like when you heard about, well, first of all, the guilty verdict and then his sentence? I mean, was it a mixed emotion for you or was it just absolute relief?
Oh, it's so hard. It's it was actually a mixed emotion on the day when we heard about it. It's like we'd gone for 4 years just trying to put this together and make sure that it goes to trial and make sure that it's fair and, you know, get these girls justice and, you know, make sure that they're vindicated. And that was what I was gunning for. It's all about the kids, getting these kids, you know, validated and stuff. But when the actual day came, it was a shock. It was a shock. You know, this is a fellow cast member, and but you have to, you have to
kind
of
separate.
Did
you feel sorry for him, despite yourself?
I felt sorry for the whole situation, basically. You know, an interesting thing that's come out of this is since the trial is that I received so many messages from people, and this is like text messages from people that I know, private Facebook messages from people that I don't know, and I'm talking over 100, people writing to me and saying, this is my story, this is what happened to me, and I've been so shocked by it. It's much more prevalent than we understand, and that we, you know, that
exactly
we know.
Right.
So it's important
also,
that we speak up.
And also that everyone, every person thinks it's happening to them in isolation, they don't realise.
Exactly
we say
right.
now, how could it have been hidden? Because, you know, Sarah didn't know that there were, you know, a host of other girls
no
who
idea.
Were suffering. So
that's right.
You know,
and I think that the key thing here is to say, you know, if you're a parent, talk to your children early, get them it's all about communication.
But some people have come out and said that it was terrible that his reputation had been brought out in court and destroyed this way.
I don't think that's what it was about, though, was it? You know, it's about the children.
Yeah.
It's about saying, well, you can't promise. Just because you're in this position of power, you can't do that. Mm. You're no different to anyone else.
I think I feel most sorry for the wives, you know.
See, that's interesting.
He was married, Robert Hughes was married to Robin Gardner.
Yeah.
And, of course, as we know, Rolf has been married to Arwen for 50-plus years or whatever it is. And you look at them standing by their man and all this comes out in the court. And you read you read the diary of Arwen, you know, about her lonely life, and you think, poor, sad women.
It's sad all around, I think.
Mm. I think having to face up to the fact would just be so incontemplable to be married to someone like this
horrible.
That you effectively go into, and you see this, sort of, you go into a state of denial
Absolutely.
So severe you end up basically living a parallel life.
Yep.
But I think the victims still have to be
Absolutely.
Paramount, however much the other
For
family
sure,
members
yeah.
You
suffered.
Mentioned very briefly that there is more to come, that it's... When you said that, what do you actually mean? That there's...
I just think that you know, it's interesting, you know, we've got Robert and we have Rolf and it's all from a certain era.
Mm.
It's all 20, 30 years ago, and I think that there's many others from that era that will be outed.
Yeah, that's
really?
Right. And also, of course, when people see that justice is done, even if their sentence was probably a little light in Rolf's
courage.
Case...
I think it's encouraging for the victims with each case that rolls on.
Mm.
They say, you know what, something is being done.
Yes.
Maybe I will speak up.
People are listening.
People
Absolutely.
And believing us.
And I think the belief system so far has been no one's going to believe me, you know? And so it's a good thing.
You're doing wonderful work with Braveheart.
Braveheart's fantastic.
Yeah, you're doing such a great job. We're really happy to have you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.